Aditya Chopra, he came there, and in between shots, he's narrating the story of DDLJ to me. And we reached the interval, so I told him, Adi, I like your story. Ma'am, your role is going to come after the interval. I said, it's a very beautiful story. I'm doing it. I'll listen to the whole story. So I remember Shahrukh giving me all the reactions, you know, that I was showing the sari. So he's there. That's a separate shot. But he stood there and he gave me all the cues, which was really amazing at that time. Right. You know, I remember in Prem Granth, you know, I had to wear these. I was playing the role of a prostitute. I was wearing this low-cut dress. I used to fight with Chimpuji every day. I said, you're like your grand, like your Raj Saab. He used to expose his heroines. So, why are you exposing me?
Ma'am, thank you so much for taking out the time to talk to us today.
It's a pleasure.
So, ma'am, first thing I want to ask you is, you know, I've read and seen many of your interviews, and you grew up with a science and theater background.
Yeah.
So when did the acting bug bite you, and why did you decide acting over science? Because you were also a topper in science.
Yeah, actually, the acting bug bit me very early. In fact, I was sort of an all-rounder kind of a student. I mean, I was doing acting also, plus I was good in studies and I was doing debating. And you know, my father, you know, since he'd been to Calcutta, and he was very, I'm actually a Pahadi, a Garhwali, Uttarakhandi. So, you know, for that time in Dehradun, I'm talking about, I think it must be already, it must be almost 35 years back. So he was very advanced of his time. So he used to feel, you know, I still remember my mom used to tell him, "Arey bhai, she's running around, she should learn housework also." So my father used to ask, why? Because I had a brother also. And he used to, he made it a point to treat us as equals. So he says, why? Kya, does he do the housework? So why should she do it? So she's, but she's, when she gets married, she was like a typical mother. I mean, any mother would say, what will she do? So I said, so my father said, she's a girl, she has to decide what she wants to do. I remember when I was in school, I was in the Doon school, which was primarily a boys' school. I happened to be there because my dad used to teach there. So one of the teachers, the headmaster's wife actually, Mrs. Martin, she was a foreigner. So she used to tell me, Himani, why don't you join the films? So I said, what, films? No, no, I'm not going to do films. I never thought of it because in our family, everyone was from education, you know. So it was very simple that time, in our time. It was, if you were good in studies, you took up science. If you were bad in studies, you took up the arts. So I took up science, organic chemistry, and I kept on doing my BSc and my MSc. But I continued doing theatre. And while I was doing my MSc organic chemistry, somebody from NSD, because NSD at that time was not so well known.
The NSD.
So we didn't know NSD. So when they came and did a workshop, we did a play of Brecht called Three Penny Opera. Then I realized, oh shit, there's an institution which is teaching you dramatics. So I became very fascinated. So then it clicked. That is the time when it clicked. I said, that's where I want to go. And at that time, since I was a very brilliant student, I got a scholarship to do MS abroad. So I first didn't break up.
Dharam Sankat.
But you know, I was very clear that I want to go to NSD. So I went to give my visa. And I also gave the interview for NSD. Fortunately, I got selected and I got a letter. When I got the letter, then I came to, went to my father. I said, Papa, I don't want to go to America. I want to go to Delhi. So my father tried to sort of reason it out with me. He says, Mani, he could also see that I know that tumhara shauk hai. So why don't you go abroad? You study there and then you come back and you can continue your theatre. So I told my father, I said, Papa, maybe when I'm in my 40s, I might have money, I might have a position in society, but I don't want to carry that regret that I had this dream and I didn't follow it. So my father didn't say anything else.
Yeah.
Although there was a huge hue and cry, my relatives, you know, my chachas and my mamas and my mamas, mama especially, they were very loud. This is kya UP mein how they say kya bhand banegi, nautanki karegi.
Ma'am, you know, one of your biggest and earliest films, Hum Aapke Hain Kaun, finished 25 years this year.
Yeah.
Hum Saath Saath has also finished 20 years this year.
Yeah.
What are some of your fondest memories of those two films?
Well, Hum Aapke Hain Kaun was my first big commercial film.
Correct.
Because although when I was in Delhi, I had done the first English film which was made in India, which was written by Arundhati Roy.
Yes.
Directed by Pradeep Krishnan. It's called Where Annie Gives It Those Ones.
Yeah.
So I was part of that. Aajkal to English films ho gaye, but it was the first English film of its time.
Right.
And but Hum Aapke Hain Kaun was my first commercial film. When this film was offered to me, I was in big awe, because when I went on the set the first time, there was Madhuri Dixit, who was number one that time, and Salman Khan was there. He was not number one that time, but he was still a star.
Yeah.
He was a star.
Yeah.
And so were most of the actors. Yeah. Like there was Reema Lagu, there was Anupam Kher, there was Satish Shah.
Yeah.
Everybody was a star.
Binduji.
Binduji was there.
Yeah.
Legend, you know.
Yeah.
So I remember when I went there, and Suraji, you know how he is.
Yeah.
He introduced me. Madhuri was sitting there. Yeah. And he took me. He says, Madhuri ji, she's Himani Shivpuri from Delhi, a very fine actor. So Madhuri got up.
Yeah.
You know, Madhuri is still
the Madhuri.
Yeah, the Madhuri Dixit. I was so touched that
yeah.
here is this. She got up and she wished
yeah.
me. And
yeah.
So, you know, everybody was treated very with great respect, because, you know, at that time, commercial film, at that time, you know, it was mainly hero heroine dominated. Hero dominated, keh sakte hain aap. Thodi bahut heroine ko bhi respect milti thi. But, you know, character artists were. Okay times,
हाँ.
except the male,
हाँ.
उनको फिर भी respect मिलती थी. We were dime a dozen,
yeah.
you know. Hum Aapke Hain Kaun was simply marvelous, you know, especially the outdoor in Ooty.
Yeah.
And, you know, I remember there used to be shots which Suraji wanted to take at 6 o'clock, because, you know, hill stations, magic hour, and evening. After three, four, there's no light.
Correct.
So, you know, we have to start very early. So, you know, and we used to get ready in the hotel at 4 o'clock.
Huh.
And not only me, matlab everyone from Binduji to Madhuri Dixit.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we were shooting in that song in which Tuffy is there and everybody's playing. There was this place. So there was just one room.
Dictana.
There was this one room, and all of us women, can you imagine? The whole gym bag lot, along with our hairdressers, changing.
Yeah.
So it was really, we had a grand time.
Yeah.
And I still remember, you know, they used to play this song,
जब
हम मुझसे जुदा होकर, तो जिसका भी लास्ट सीन होता था तो वो ये गाना गाते थे, एंड एवरीबडी उसकी आंख में आंसू होते थे. तो हमको लगता था यार हम तो नहीं, बट व्हेन माय लास्ट सीन केम एंड देन दिस सॉन्ग स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग, आई स्टिल हैव गूज़बम्प्स. सो इवन आई हैड टीयर्स इन माय आईज. We didn't know it was going to become such a big hit.
Yeah.
Even when it was released, people were making fun of it. I remember I and Madhuri, we were shooting for Raja in the Kumar's film, and you know, people were laughing. Arey yaar, kya suna, shaadi ka video bana diya. And then when it went on to become a big hit, so
yeah,
beautiful memories.
Yeah. So I have a confession to make. DDLJ, I've seen many times. My favorite scene in that film. Is the scene just mein wo saadiyan try kar rahi hain and he's saying kill rahi hain aap sach rahi hain aap. So tell me about how that film happened.
Hum Aapke Hain Kaun had happened.
Yeah.
And I was doing Z had just entered. So I was
Hasrat ne aap kar rahi
hain. I was doing Hasrat, which was a very bold serial at that time, where I played this woman who runs away with a younger person, Tabalji. So I was shooting for Hasratain, Noor Mahal, Noor Bungalow in Bandra.
Okay.
So I got a call from, that I was saying, hello, ma'am, I'm Yash Chopra's son, Aditya Chopra. So I said, okay, I didn't know that he had a son. So, because he was always very quiet that time So I'm making a film and I would like to come and narrate you the story.
Yeah.
So, you know, I was just still this young girl who had just come out of Dehradun, I mean, theatre kind of. So, it wasn't, I didn't have this image. So, you know, I like a simple person. I said, I'm shooting in Noor Bungalow, so you come there and meet me over there. So that Aditya Chopra, he came there, and in between shots, he's narrating the story of DDLJ to me. And we reached the interval, so I told him, Adi, I like your story. Ma'am, your role is going to come after the interval. I said, it's a very beautiful story. I'm doing it. I'll listen to the whole story. So that's how I did DDLJ. And that scene that you're talking about, it is also, like many other people's, it's my favorite also. Yeah. Because you see, if you just see it again once, because it keeps on coming, you know, mere aur Shah Rukh ke shots are totally separate. It's only me and the sari wala.
Right.
So I remember Shah Rukh giving me all the reactions, you know, that I was showing the sari. So he's there. That's a separate shot. But he stood there and he gave me all the cues, which was really amazing at that time, you know, where we had, I won't name the actors, who weren't even there to give the cues. Because giving the cues is a totally foreign concept. Aajkal toh ho gaya hai hamari filmon mein. But us time it was totally, and some actors never gave their cues. And when they gave the cues, they gave such idiotic cues ki it's better that they don't give the cues. I mean, I won't mention them also.
Sure.
So Shah Rukh was this amazing actor. You know, he was giving all the cues even when he was not in the... So that is why I think that scene has come out so beautiful.
I went to see the film in Maratha Mandir a few years ago, and abhi bhi us scene pe utni hi seatiyan
talkaan. That's what Shah Rukh told me, you know, when the film released.
Yeah.
And that also became a huge success. So Shah Rukh, at that time we were doing a lot of films. So Shah Rukh told me, Himani ji, have you seen the film? Because we had seen it in trials. You must go and see it in the hall. Itni seatiyan bachti hai aapki entry mein, he's telling me. And I still remember at that time, you know, once film fair mein, Shah Rukh has made a note. He was asked, what are your top 10 favorite actresses? So usme Hollywood ki bhi thi, kuch like Meryl Streep, hamare Bollywood se thi. Bollywood is a very bad term. Madhuri Dixit and all that. And he had mentioned me also, which was so touching. That was so touching.
My other, I think, most favorite scene of yours amongst all your films that I've seen is Pardesh mein ek scene hai, jis mein you start yelling at Mahima Chaudhary. She says, Bua, main Rajiv ke saath kheton mein jaun.
I was about to mention that scene. There's a huge soliloquy of mine. And you know, Shah Rukh is also there.
He's on the chat. He's listening
to
you.
He's on the chat. So you know, we rehearsed for that also.
Acha.
So that's what I was about to mention, that even in Pardesh, there's one huge sequence and I'm just going blah, 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 blah. And he stood there, he gave me all the cues.
Oh, wow.
I'm very fond memory.
You know, you've done a whole gamut of roles. How do you draw your inspiration to stay fresh? Har bua alag hoti hai, har mami alag hoti hai aapki. But how do you stay fresh?
You know, acting is my passion. And since, unfortunately, I've been trained National School of Drama and I did a lot of theatre. So we had this thing that each person is different. So, you know, at that time, nowadays the scenario is very much different. That time is that if you a film of yours got hit, if you're a bua, so you got 10 more roles, of which I could select only 4 or 5. So I tried to get a little bit of difference. If you see the Paradesh ki bua is totally different, and DDLJ hero number one ki bua is also
more modern
different.
And
so you know, it's not some magic that I could only do. It's just that it's like in a family, if there are two sisters, they're totally alike, because each person is his own. I managed in that time not to get typecast in the sense that I felt people used to say that like in males there was Anupam who was doing both comedy and tragedy and villainish. I was doing a vampish, I was doing Prem Granth along with
Rifat Bhi. Kuch kuch hota hai.
In Rifat Bhi, like, that is totally different.
Yeah.
And Mehndi, which is another negative kind. And I did positive also. And I did comic films, so did very well. It's because, well, I was fortunate. I am fortunate.
Yeah.
Wall Skinner. that comedy timing, fortunately, I have it. So, because that is a little tough.
Yeah.
You can do a serious acting. That is because, you see, it's very difficult to make people laugh.
Right.
It's easy to make the people cry. Because, you know, people cry not because of course, your acting convinces them, but they remember their own pain.
Yeah.
And then they cry.
Correct.
But to make people laugh is you have to make them forget their
whatever pain or
frustration they have in their life, and then they can enjoy. That requires something special.
If you had to pick one role that has been the most challenging, which one and why?
But yeah, sometimes, you know, when I did a little over the top roles, you know, or like, you know, I remember in Prem Granth, you know, I had to wear these, I was playing the role of a prostitute. I was wearing this low-cut dress. I used to fight with Chimpuji every day. I said, you're like your grand, like your Raj Saab, he used to expose his heroines. So, mere ko kyun expose kar raha hai? So that was a little against me, because basically I'm a very, although the roles I've done are a little, I don't know, they're not the quieter kind,
correct,
which you've done well.
The peppiness
is there, the zanniness in them. But I'm more of a quiet person. Like, you know, if you ask me, basically, I'm a sort of, I'm happy with a book. In between shots, I'm reading a book. Or, you know, I am a budding writer. You can say I've always been writing since you told me you're a writer. So I'm a quieter kind of a person.
Ma'am, itne roles aapne kare hain. What is that one role that you feel abhi bhi karna baki hai? I'm still waiting to do something like this.
Oh, yeah, so many roles. When I see Meryl Streep doing all these roles, like, you know, when she does this Iron Lady or
The Devil Wears Prada.
Yeah, you know, these kind of roles. And I said, wow, I mean,
yeah,
when are we going to get those kind of roles,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Because here, in our, unfortunately, in our industry, even a person like Anurag Kashyap, when he's doing a story of these 80-year-old women who are happy shooters, he picks up young actors. But although they're very good, I'm not saying they're very good. Tapsee Pannu and
Bhumi,
they're very fine actors, saying. But aisa nahi hota. Hollywood maybe they're very fine, but they will not cast Jennifer Lawrence in Meryl Streep's Iron Lady.
Correct.
You know? But
correct.
Hamare yahan kya hoga? They will take Jennifer Lawrence, she's the number one. They will make her the Margaret Thatcher or you know, the role with Glenn Close. It's super according to your age.
Yeah.
And first of all, they cannot even think of doing a role in which hum to bechare character artists, even our leading ladies, what are they doing?
Sure.
Madhuri ji or Shilpa ji, what they're becoming the judges in reality shows. No? Where do they get films which centers around them?
Mm-hmm. Remember, you are one of those few actors that despite doing such big films, you've also done television equally.
Yes.
What balance aapne kaise maintain
kara? No, yeah, people used to ask me, because at one time when I started doing these commercial films which were very successful, like
the Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham,
the whole films, but I still continued doing TV, and people used to laugh at me. They said, are you mad? You're working with Subhash Ghai, you're working with Rajshri, you're working with Yash Raj, Karan Johar, why the hell are you doing TV? So I tell you, no, I'm a little, wo kehti na, satki bhi. So, but I used to say ki nahi bhai, main TV se mujhe naam mila. So I will not, I'm not the kind of person who just seedhi se chadhi usko laat maarti. Us time the people used to make fun, but now the scenario is totally different.
Yeah.
I remember when I was doing Main Prem Ki Diwani Hoon, because now since Mr. Bachchan came with KBC, now respect is really gone up, and you see lot of actors,
they're all on TV,
they're
doing
all
something
on TV doing something or the other. Now TV is not looked down as that time, but that time I'm talking about, this is about 25 years back, TV was the wo jo kehte na sautela bhai hota tha ki aap kyun kar rahe ho jabki aapke paas sage bhai ke saath. I was known because I did that role of Devki Bhoja in Hum Rahe at that time, there was Doordarshan. So the whole of India got to know me because of that. So I said TV made me what I am. So I will not kick that ladder which I climbed with.
But speaking of Hum Rahe, is it true, maine kahin padha tha that you were offered Hum Log?
This was the time when I was doing theatre, and I was passionate about theatre. And when the first TV serial Hum Log was being made,
yeah.
So you know, Manoj Ram Joshi, the writer of Hum Log, so he had seen me performing. So you know, he'd gone to Kumar Vasudev, ki badi achhi actress hai, usko bulao yaar, chutki ke liye sahi rahegi. So they called me. I said, TV serial? Oh, acha. So they said ki Spanish soap opera hai, uske jaisa Hum Log bana rahe hain. Hafte mein do din. Imagine now we are doing dailies. Hafte mein do din. I said, what? Hafte mein do din? So I'll have to give up theater. हाँ, मनोज शर्मा जी, देखो बेटा theater वाला छोड़ना पड़ेगा. मैंने कहा मैं theater नहीं छोड़ूंगी. But that time there was this जुनून कि theater में जीना, theater में. I said sorry, I'm not doing it. So when I did Hamrai, this was about 7 or 8 years बाद में. This is the same writer Manoj Shyam Joshi. Okay. He had written this and he had written a beautiful character of Devki Pauchai. So in Bombay mein they log bana rahe the. So Kumar Sinha asked him ki aisi koi actress hai Delhi mein, Bombay mein pal. This is hai to ek Himani Bhatta ke Bhat ka time. Puri pagal hai, usne Hum Log to bana kar diya, to pooch ke dekh le. So and more than me, I had got married. Then my husband was very keen because he came from the filmy family.
Correct.
He says, ये बड़ा अच्छा opportunity है, चलो चलो Bombay चलते हैं. मैंने कहा यार तुम जाओ, मैं इधर ही खुश हूँ. He says, नहीं नहीं, you also come, come. So my husband, you know what he did? He says, जाके बना रहा पूरा furniture बिकवा दिया. मैंने कहा अलमारी उसको दे दी.
So
you know, he had to literally push me, drag me. I had no intention of coming to Mumbai. So anyway, I came to this, I started doing this serial and it suddenly became so popular,
right.
Especially my character, that you know. So you know, people used to ask me ki aap kya karte ho, to jaise hota na ki koi kehta main accounting karta hu, main ye karta hu, to I said theater karti hu. Nahi nahi, wo to theek hai, lekin waise kya karte ho? Jaise theater matlab shauk hai. So you know, it was very difficult to explain to them that I'm doing theater professionally. And once I did this Hamaki,
yeah,
I mean I this Hamrai, then I didn't have to explain to anybody.
Right, everybody knew.
Because Doordarshan hi tha us time, so it had such a big reach.
So
that's how.
Ma'am, in conclusion, so many years of experience, aspiring actors ko, what is the one thing you think they should do and what is the one thing they should not do? What is that advice you would give for them?
Advice, it's very difficult to give advice because each person has its own destiny, especially in our line. But I feel that always dream big. Never compromise. Dream big. And what you should not do is never give up on your dreams.
Excellent. Thank you so much, ma'am. We appreciate
it. It's a pleasure.
Thank you so much.